The entertained Phil Thomas Cat here, and welcome, my friends, to the Best of UZ 2012 countdown. We'll be counting down the top music videos that were uploaded, either brand new videos, classic music videos that we uploaded from our archives as we've been restoring them. And of course, there were some submissions from other areas, other places in the world. All of these will be included in the UZ countdown for 2012, based entirely on YouTube views.
I don't want you to play just too much.
All right, Leo, let's have a little.
Golden fingers, and we're loved everywhere we go. We sing about beauty and we sing about truth at $10,000 a show. We take all kind of pills and give us all kind of thrills, but the thrill we'll never know is the thrill that'll get you when you get your picture on the cover of the Rolling Stone.
Rolling Stone.
Wanna see my picture on the cover?
Stone.
Wanna buy 5 copies for my mother?
Stone.
Wanna see my smiling face on the cover of the Rolling Stone?
That's a very good idea.
Cross that sea, but you'll be home waiting for me. It takes a little time to catch up to my thoughts of something so special that I once lost. When I get back home, I won't be alone. That damn telephone won't ring anymore.
Hurricane partier Phil Thomas Cat here. Several years ago, I made it out to the Flora-Bama during Hurricane Danny. The place was packed, and NBC Dateline was there shooting a segment talking about hurricane partying, Bama style. On stage was the legendary Rusty McHugh and Mike Fincher doing one of their classics.
Well, it's a big old toy car stuff. That's what I bought it for. My truck is a good old boy. It ain't pretty. I know such a bird, it ain't fast. A lot of fun to hurt in these pains. I have a real carry. It's a good old gas and it'll get you there. I'm in my truck for a whole lot of life. We can keep running, but we don't mind the fight. We wash up in the creek while my dog goes swimming. We get tanked up and get up to chase with my truck. It's a good old boy, my truck.
From the Florida Gulf Coast to around the world, the Uncharted Zone.
The most popular jam session on the coast, Chances, 9401 North Davis Highway, invites you to attend the Friday afternoon jam session. The Gulf Coast Darts Capital, 9401 North Davis Highway, Pensacola.
One of the cool things to happen this year is the fact that Dr. Norman Vickers received the key to the city for his involvement and his contribution to the jazz community of this area. You say, congratulate you, Norm.
If we can get Dr. Norman Vickers up here, we want to give him the keys to the city of Pensacola.
Whoa! Yay, Norman! Woo! Woo!
Come on over here to the mic. Here he is, Mr. Jazz himself.
Yay! Woo!
Thank you. On behalf of the 500 members of the Jazz Society, I accept this. Thank you very much.
Well, I want to read it. Isn't this beautiful? We're really giving him a big key to the city of Pensacola because he is a very important part of our community.
Yes, indeed.
It says, presented to Dr. F. Norman Vickers, Volunteer Executive Director Emeritus, Jazz Society of Pensacola, for his enthusiastic dedication and commitment to the Jazz Society of Pensacola and organizing the Pensacola Jazz Fest. Ashton J. Hayward, the third mayor, April 14, 2012.
Yeah. Thank you, Councilman Myers, and thank you, City of Pensacola. Like I say, I accept this for the 500 members of the Jazz Society.
Oh,
it's been a lot of fun. I've gotten more than I've contributed.
Oh,
thank you.
Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, for Dr. Norman Vickers.
The apprehensive Phil Thomas Cat here. And the music video that I have lined up for you is by UZ Talent Search winner, Gabrielle Wilson. She did a fantastic job performing this at the event and here in the video.
Hi there, Tommy Robinetti here with contestant number 5, Gabrielle Wilson. How are you?
I'm having a hot flash.
That's what I heard. Fantastic.
We need to bring this out into public. If we can have erectile dysfunction, we can have hot flashes.
Well, we've got the air conditioner behind us. Hopefully that'll do some good.
Yes, but it's getting you and not me, which is why your little thing's getting smaller.
And that's why I'm digging
beard.
It.
I'm in his beard.
Well, you did the song Angie Baby by Helen Reddy. I thought it was a great song. I thought you did
a great job.
What made you do that?
You know, when I was a kid, my mother got the Helen Reddy, I Am Woman, Hear Me Roar. And between Helen Reddy, Frank Sinatra, and show tunes, that's what I grew up on.
I thought you did a great job. As soon as I heard the first two notes, I was like, oh, man, that's Angie, baby. Because you just don't hear that song much anymore at all.
No. No, and another one that I like to do of hers is the Ruby Redress.
Oh, great song. Another great song. But, you know, that was a great era back then. She had a string of hits roll out.
Yes, she did.
You live your life in the songs you hear on the rock and roll radio. And when a young girl doesn't have any friends, that's a really nice place to go. Folks hoping you'd turn out cool, but they have to take you out of school. You're a little touched, you know, Angie baby. Lovers up here in your room each night, and they whirl you across the floor. But they always seem to fade away when your daddy taps on the door. Angie girl, are you alright? Tell the radio goodnight. All alone once more, Angie baby. blind. I see your thoughts are far away. Would you dance with me today? I'll show you how to have a good time, baby.
While looking through the archives, though, I come across some very cool footage of Southern Breeze and Ronnie Miller special reports that we shot back in the early days of UZ. Check out a clip of this.
When I was 12 years old, in 1969, my dad passed away, and I picked up the guitar. It was my mother's guitar, actually, and she played in church, and I used to go and sit on the back pew and listen to her for hours upon hours, and she was a writer also, but she wrote nothing but gospel, and I just admired her so much, and I used to sneak in her bedroom and get her guitar out from under the bed, and she'd go to town with the next door neighbors and stuff and her friends, and I'd get that guitar out, and I'd just start banging away at it, and one day she came home and caught me, and I thought I was going to go get a whipping for sure, but instead of spanking me, she said, well, show me what you got.
Well, here's a song from back in that same era. A classic song that we dug out of the archives, especially for you. Here's Southern Breeze and She's a Lover.
She's a lover. Yeah, she's a lover. I can hear it in the way she talks, and I see that wiggle. She's a lady, a prim and proper lady. She keeps her secret undercover, and underneath, that lady's a lover.
The Unstable, Phil Thomas Cat here. This next music video was requested by Jesse Romaine, who's the director of video production at Stellar Media up in North Carolina. He wanted to hear this live version of Ricky Whitley performing Psycho Mama. Now, this was the first night that I ever shot at the world-famous Flora-Bama Lounge. That same night, I recorded Lillian Highway Blues and, of course, some classic Rusty McHugh tunes as well. But here he is, Ricky Whitley himself, with the live version to Psycho Mama on the Uncharted Zone.
How about a round of applause for Phil Thomas Cat? He's out here tonight, and he's taping us tonight. We had a request for Psycho Mama. We're going to do that. This goes out to PTK. Fry some fish, mama, 'cause I'm hungry as can be. Lordy, how I wish, mama, you could keep that baby quiet, 'cause my head sure hurt me. I saw my ex again last night, mama, at a dance at Miller's store. She was with that Jackie White, mama, I killed them both and buried him under Jenkins sycamore. Think I'm psycho, don't you, mama? Mama, pour me a cup. Think I'm psycho, don't you, mama? Better let him lock me up.
Another big resurgence this year in 2012 is the Taste Like Chicken movement, the restaurant movement. Well, they've reopened, and the popularity is better than ever. You know, the Taste Like Chicken downtown's finally reopening.
Well, the problem is they had rats, and for a long time they were on the menu anyway. So somebody just thought, well, somebody's left the cage open there in the back.
Well, they've cleaned all that up now.
Cleaned it all up, and, you know, they were actually open anyway. You know, I mean, you couldn't go in the front. You could always go around back, and they'd serve you. You know, no big deal.
Tastes Like Chicken, downtown. Phil Thomas Cat here.
And Tommy Robinetti here.
You know, it's Roadkill Weekend coming up at Tastes Like Chicken. You go into that?
I don't know, man. Last Roadkill Weekend, there was a lot of grit in my meat. But, you know, if they clean that up, then yeah, sure, why not?
Okay, well, maybe they will. They could boil that out.
You'd think so.
Well, don't miss it. It's going to be a lot of fun, a lot of interesting alternative meats. It's Roadkill Weekend. It Tastes Like Chicken downtown.
Oh, don't forget the Tastes Like Chicken babes are going to be out too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I like it when they come. Coming up this Saturday, it tastes like chicken. It's Crow Fest.
You know what's funny about this is Phil couldn't stand Taste Like Chicken. I used to bring stuff from Taste Like Chicken and all that, and he didn't want no part of it. And I remember getting sick a couple of times. I'd take him to Taste Like Chicken. We'd eat some exotic meats and all that. He really wasn't into it. Then they started sponsoring the show, started throwing money at him. Next thing you know, he's there every week. So what did you have this week?
TLC Special Sauce will make Crow your favorite fowl to eat.
I cannot believe they paid you to say that.
Yeah, that's the new motto on that.
I know, but that sauce is really good, though, but I cannot believe he's you know, I bet him $20. There's no way he would get you to say that. I guess I owe him 20 bucks. But they love you down there. It tastes like chicken. Aren't you supposed to do some songs down there on a weekend or something sometime soon?
Yeah.
Song Fest? Yeah, what I thought.
Like on one of them gallery nights.
I heard Chuck talking about that.
Yeah.
Well, that'll be cool. All right.
You gotta come down.
I don't get down there very much anymore.
Not even for gallery night?
I've just been working late and stuff, working on projects and stuff, but I would love to get back down to Taste Like Chicken. You been there for the Thursday night Pasta Fest?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. Pasta with anything, with a capital A. I mean anything, any kind of meat you want. Tastes Like Chicken, Daddy.
Downtown. The High Tech, Phil Thomas Cat here. And I'm here with Russ Maines of Regular Joe 3.0. What's with the 3.0, Russ?
Well, I'll be honest with you, Phil. There's some trouble with the 2.0 version of the band, and, well, I decided to do a little upgrade.
Look out below.
This has been a very fun year. I've been digging through the archives. I've had some sponsorship that's helped me to accomplish this. And I found some very cool, unusual, and unique stuff. One of the treasures that I come across was Rusty McHugh over at Perdido Cove Restaurant, where we were shooting the side scenes, the B-roll footage, I guess you could call it, for the very famous Rusty McHugh and Mike Venture music video, I Never Met a Bitch That Could Eat So Much. Well, here's a little behind the scenes look at that extremely fun afternoon.
When I went somewhere in Puerto Rico without this original,
yeah. Get
my hand, okay?
Yeah, this would be perfect. Let's do it right now.
Yeah.
Okay. Look shocked.
I need to get his hands there.
Yeah.
And our lunch specials.
Yeah,
all right, hold
on. Okay, do it faster.
My adventure into the archive. Well, it's put me in the possession of some wonderful jewels from the Gulf Coast music scene history. I come across an interview in these archives by a band named Blind Driver. They were a cool little classic rock band that played quite a bit back in the early 90s.
Hi there, Phil Thomas Cat here, and welcome my friends to the Uncharted Zone. We're out here at Florida Town Beach, or whatever they call this.
This is Florida Town, out right by out of Pace here.
And this is the very talented Blind Driver. I'm going to let each of you guys introduce yourselves to the viewing public.
I'm Harold Taylor.
I'm Tom Owsley.
Walt Tallman.
I'm Johnny Spring.
And how long have you guys been playing together as Blind Driver?
2 years.
2 years?
A little over 2 years, sir.
Well, I noticed you've got a new drummer here, other than the one that was in the videos that I shot out at Sandy's a while back. He's got a broken leg there?
Broken foot.
What? That kind of worries me. What'd you do with the other drummer?
We hurt him bad.
I want to send a shout out to Taylor. Mason sends a belated happy birthday. And while we're doing shout outs, I'd also like to congratulate Uncle Dangerous, who took a lovely bride this year. The slightly impaired Phil Thomas Cat here. And this next music video is by a group from Dublin, Ireland. The eccentric Uncle Dangerous, along with his ruthless keyboardist Auntie Cautious. Well, they've been lurking in the underground comedy circuit since 2008 with their own music genre, Uneasy Listening. Between death threats and furthering the list of venues which they are banned from, Uncle Dangerous has been pushing the borders of Irish so-called weirdo music. Uncle Dangerous and Auntie Cautious have been striving to finish their first album, Buttons and Puppies and Bullocks Like That. Here they are with a space opera, Tribot 4000, on the Uncharted Zone.
Station 2242. The last of the human race sent into space to colonize distant planets. Food shortages has led to the sole production of cherry trifle. The TR-4000.
Robots! Robots! Robots!
Please, share the Uncharted Zone with your friends.
Been doing business here 20 years and having a good time doing it. One beer and lousy pizza at Papa Rocco's. For the most part, we're busy every weekend with the, we do different live bands here.
Are you a musician yourself?
No. Once in a while, I'll get up there and sing a song or two, but if I had to do it for a living, I'd be in bad shape. I'm sick of baking pizzas.
Well, I guarantee you got some good food here. We had some the night we came out here, and it was delicious.
Yeah, well, I appreciate that. And so, anybody out there, man, come on by, and I'll take good care of you. And so, then good to see you all down here.
A number of great musicians have had the honor to play with the, well, a legendary musician that lives in the area these days, Greg Philbin, formerly of the REO Speedwagon Band. Well, several years ago, UZ's Mike Roycroft tracked him down. And guess what? We dug it up out of the archives as we're restoring this wonderful, huge archival thing. We appreciate all your support and help to get this done. Anyway, here's a clip of Mike Roycroft and that famous interview that he had with Greg Philbin.
Hi, this is Mike for the Uncharted Zone. I'm very thrilled to have our special guest today, Mr. Greg Philbin, a founding member and the original bass player for REO Speedwagon. How are you doing today, Greg?
Doing great, thank you.
I wanted to talk to you a little bit about your time in the band and what you've been up to since then. Tell me about how the band got started. You guys were all in school together up in Illinois, is that correct?
Yeah, we got started at the University of Illinois in Urbana-Champaign, and They were together for 1 year, and I was with another band at the time. My band was breaking up, and their bass player was graduating, so I joined with Neil and Alan, and then there were the three original members, and then we picked up a singer and various guitar players through the years.
Now, I don't know how many people out there know this, but you guys had kind of a series of singers there in and around Kevin Cronin. Must have been kind of frustrating for you guys to spend a few years waiting to find your niche with one singer, huh?
Well, what happened, we started with the original singer, Terry Luttrell, And then we had problems with him, and we got Kevin. And then Kevin kind of lost his voice. He was only 19 or so at the time, had never been away from home. And so we replaced him with Mike Murphy, who was a local fixture. And then we had Mike for a couple of albums, and then went back to Kevin when he had gotten his voice back together and his personal life together. And he's been with him ever since. And it was difficult at the time because we were basically a live band, and we sold albums because of live performances, and people just didn't know what to expect, you know, next time we came around. So the first project that we did with Kevin when we got back together was do all of our best material from the first five or so albums and put those on a live album with Kevin singing them, and that kind of unified the whole image and concept.
The instinctive Phil Thomas Cat here. And as you know, I've been rumbling through the UZ archives in the Flora-Bama department lately, and I've been finding some really cool stuff. I come across something by, from what I understand, according to legend, was the first songwriter to perform at the Flora-Bama, Ken Lambert. Now this was him way back in the 90s with a really funny little tune. Now of course, Ken these days has devoted most of his time to Sunshine Ministries, but back in the day, he wrote this funny song.
This is a love song. It happened here at the Flora-Bama not too terribly long ago. I wrote it for a friend of mine. Fell in love here with a young girl. It was kind of late. They'd had a couple of drinks. She was a doll, but it was damn near closing time, and I was drunk, so I said, hey, don't you let me take you home? She said, why not? Don't get any bright ideas, cause I ain't that tight. And I said, hey, never even crossed my mind. I was a perfect gentleman, and we were driving home. She kept making moves and saying things that turned me on. She hungered for my body, it was plain enough to see. That woman needed loving, Lord, she needed it from me. Oh, now I'm just a man, and any man can't stand to see a woman beg, so I came in, figured it might change her luck. As I recall, it wasn't really very hard to satisfy, but after all, you only charged me $50. Thank you, music lovers.
The UZ Archives Preservation Project has, well, it's taken us into many directions. I came across what's likely the first comedy skit between myself and Tommy Robinetti. This was from back in 1995. It's pretty funny. Check out a clip.
And now the marine forecast.
Here's the marine forecast, sir. Seas 1 to 3 feet. Winds out of the north at 14 knots. Water temperature 81 degrees. Light chaparral protected waters. That's the marine forecast, sir.
Now here's the forecast.
Foam. It's the foam, foam, foam.
Sunny skies in store today, so you can go to the beach with your baby and play.
Cause in the afternoon when the showers come, be off the beach, sure it's for your fun.
High near 90, low of 75, that's the forecast to help you plan your life.
We'll see you next week with the forecast wrap. Let's get something to eat and cut this crap.
Yeah, I'm with you, man. Let's go.
Very sad news happened in 2012 also. We lost a Gulf Coast legend, Larry Butler, who was a Grammy-winning songwriter and producer, and who was from the Pensacola area, passed away. Here's a little clip from a little special report he put together right around the time of his passing.
I tell you, On the song, I know this is the song that's one of your best known, is the Somebody Done Somebody Wrong song. Where did the inspiration for that thing come from? Do you have a story on that?
I sure do. A friend of mine, Chips Moman, who is also a record producer and a great songwriter, he and I were at his home one night shooting pool. And he said, Larry, I've got this idea for a song. I can't finish it. He said, I've had the idea for about 2 years. And I said, let me hear it. So he picked up the guitar and he said, it's lonely out tonight, the feeling just got right. He sang the opening of the song. And as soon as he did, I said, hey, won't you play another Somebody Done Somebody? We wrote it in 20 minutes.
Wow, that's fascinating. I tell you, you know, I remember when I was probably 12, 13 years old, a friend of mine says, hey, this song by B.J. Thomas was written by somebody from Pensacola named Larry Butler. And so I grabbed the record. You know, I wasn't real familiar with it because I was pretty young at the time. I looked at it. I went, wow, how cool is that? I never thought that I would actually be able to meet the man that wrote this big hit. I tell you, it's a pleasure, and I appreciate it.
Oh, thank you very much. I'm very proud of that song. I mean, it broke down all barriers. It wasn't a country song. It wasn't a pop song. It was everything. It was easy listening, adult contemporary. And which, you know, I'm very proud of it. I'd love to have another one just like that, you know?
It's lonely out tonight, and the feeling just got right. The brand new love song. Somebody done somebody wrong song. So hey, won't you play another Somebody Done Somebody Wrong song to make me feel at home. I'll miss my baby. Please play for me sad melody, so sad makes everybody cry. A real hurting song about a love that's gone wrong. 'Cause I don't wanna cry all alone. So please, won't you please another Somebody Done Somebody.
The number 8 music video for the year on UZ was a submission from Reno, Nevada. This is a great tune and a great little music video as well. It's Kirk Witt and Michael Fasano, a song called Silver Bahama. If you've been following UZ, Jim Simino's career has had an upswing this year with a previous song called Home that also charted on this countdown. Well, during the time that we were producing that music video and the number 7 music video for the year, we put together a little bio for Jim to use in, well, whatever endeavors he has. Here's a clip.
I was born in Pensacola, Florida, NES. Pensacola, where my dad was stationed at. Music was always a big thing around my house, having 4 older sisters. They would play with me and my brothers with records and things. And I was really inspired. The first inspiration I got was my sister. My 4 sisters would put me and my two other brothers in whitey tighties at the age of 4 and 5. And they'd stick us in the corner of the house, cut off all the lights, and take a lamp and cover up the back with a blanket and have a spotlight. Then they'd put on the Beatles and Paul Revere and the Raiders and Rolling Stones. And we would actually lip sing and play air guitar with brooms and mops and sticks. And when the record was over, they'd jump up and scream and clap and yell. And I kind of liked that.
This next music video was written by Stevie Mack and Kirby Carr and recorded by Jim Simino. And it's become the number 7 music video on the Best of UZ 2012. Here's I Want Love Too on the Uncharted Zone.
You never know what the future holds when you fall in love. You roll the dice, then you hold on tight when times get rough. I kept holding on while she was letting go. And now she's gone, and I'm alone, and all that I know. She's torn me all apart. I feel love, won't real love. And it's burning me down in my heart to think about but live without love. It's more than I can do. I want love too.
This next music video, I'm sure, is a fluke. It's the number 6 music video for the year on UZ, according to our video views on YouTube. It's a tune that I recorded with radio legend Linda Lawrence, proclaiming that one of us can't sing. The year's number 6 music video on the Best of 2012 for UZ.
You know why they call him eccentric? Well, some of the stuff that happens over here, that's the only way we can describe it. If not, we'd have to Baker act him.
I've been making records since I was in my teens. I've been writing love songs for girls whom I've gave rings. But there seems to be some flat notes, and I don't think it's me. Judging from the harmonies, one of us can't sing. Musically, there's problems, that might be too extreme. Judging from your flat notes, one of us can't sing.
One of the projects that I worked on this year was digitizing the movie that I put together for the Hurricane Ivan disaster that happened here back in 2004. It's Hurricane Ivan, a view from the Northeast Quadrant. Here's a clip from that project.
Back before the storm, hurricanes around here were considered somewhat of a novelty. People looked at them with a sense of excitement and anticipation, and even enjoyed the slightly nasty weather.
Hurry, hurry, scurry from the hurricane, batten down the hatches when we go.
After all, for most folks, it was a vacation from work with almost a holiday-type atmosphere.
Andrew, Aaron, Hugo, Annie, Opal, Bertha, George, or Danny. By any other name, it's still a hurricane. Ooh, ah, listen to that wind howl. We're having a hurricane party now.
At 2:08 p.m., Mobile Doppler weather.
The tropical innocence that had reigned in the area for so long was ripped away from us on 9/16. And for those of us who stayed, life will never be the same.
The number 5 music video on UZ had a little breeze itself. The band Southern Breeze and their latest, Sugar Daddy, on the best of 2012.
You nasty girl. Yeah! We'll hear your sugar daddy tonight. Did it make you feel alright? Oh, will you come to see me tonight? So that makes you feel good inside. Sugar daddy. Oh, yeah. You're going to need a friend. Well, but don't come knocking at my back door. Cause I found somebody and I know the score. Sugar daddy. You're a nasty girl. Your sugar daddy. Living in luxury, he's in the city. He thinks that he can do you right. Cause when he calls you, you're there every time.
Uncharted Zone. Love it like you should.
As you know, we've been working hard to digitize the entire UZ archive this year. I don't know if we're going to make it. Honestly, it doesn't look like we quite will. It's a tough, tough job. And it takes hours and hours to get this stuff restored and digitized and then put away where it needs to be put. But I come out with some great stuff this year on the stuff that I have been able to get to. One, incidentally, is Rusty and Mike at Mullet Toss. This is a little Mullet Toss interview that gets a little out of hand. Here's a clip.
Listen, I understand you've written a song just for the Mullet Toss.
Well, I got one here. Let's see if we can get through it. I'll try it for you. Well, you grab you a mullet by the tail of the gullet, and you give that thing a fling. And if you hang tough, while you might get lucky, you can throw it with the mullet queen. Or you can get... Ah, shit, we got to do it again. Can you cut that out of there somewhere?
Yeah.
Well, all right. Well, you grab you a mullet by the tail of the gullet, and you give that thing a fling. And if you hang tough, you might get lucky, you can chunk it with the mullet queen. Or you can lay in the sand and listen to the band, you can get drunk with me. Damn it, I can't do it. I got to do it again. Well, you grab your mullet by the tail or the gullet, and you give that thing a fling. If you get lucky, God dang it. Well, you grab your mullet by the tail or the gullet, and you give that thing a fling. And if you hang tough, while you might get lucky, you can chunk it with the mullet queen. Or you can go swimming or hit on the women, got everything you need. Or you can lay in the sand, listen to the band, or you can get drunk with me. Cause we drink all day and party all night, and on Sunday we praise the Lord. We make a party out of throwing dead fish now, brother. Tell me we ain't bored. Now, if you want to get you an important job, brother, we'll know we'll let you act fucking this thing all up.
Coming across some great stuff. And way back before we had a digital camera, we shot a lot of music video footage on analog tape. Of late, I've been preserving the UZ archives. I came across this great music video shot way back in 1996 at the Flora-Bama by a legendary songwriter, Rusty McHugh, and of course, his partner, Mike Fincher. This is called I Think I Feel a Song Coming On. I did not even realize that this was in my archives at all. I shot a later version with downtown Larry Brown singing lead on it. But this one's classic. It's got that cool bluesy kind of feel. You're gonna like this. Shot at the Flora-Bama before digital. Here's Rusty and Mike.
Suddenly. And the leaves were gone. And just like that, baby, baby, I was all alone. And there's this chill where it used to be so warm. Well, I think I feel a song coming on. First verse. You know it cuts like a knife, whittling away at what's left of my life. Why, it's a melancholy melody on the lips of a silent night. You know, I bet a little bit of guitar sure would be nice. Michael Fincher on the electric guitar all night long. Yes, sir.
As you may remember, Tommy Robinetti and myself ventured out to Pensacola Beach during Hurricane Isaac. Here's a clip of what we saw out there.
You can see we're white capping out on Pensacola Bay.
Just drive, okay? I got this over.
Okay, sorry.
Damn it.
As you can see, my friends, the water is very deep. Hurricane Ivan is rolling in and fear is rampant throughout the car.
Excuse me, it's Isaac.
No. Whatever. Go around, my friends. The water is deep. We are scared. Not as scared as we were 2 days ago, but fear is still rampant around the vehicle. Look at the fierce winds, they are blowing at 12 miles an hour. No one knows the extent of the fear throughout the neighborhood. They are back shooting again, we had to stop the car, the fear had gripped Phil Thomas' cat, he had to stop on the side of the road and throw up. He is okay now. But the sight of that really made me sick, so I'm a little queasy, but I would be okay. Yeah, so other people trying to shoot the video here, channel squeeze here. Why are you people harassing me on the Facebook? They're harassing me on
the
Facebook.
That you're risking your life going to Pensacola Beach to share footage.
Well, the doctor does not get out there often. But when disaster strikes, Dr. Goodenhigh likes to be there, as always. Remember, Dr. Goodenhigh office hours, 9 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Monday, and that's all.
Thank you.
safe.
The number three music video on UZ, on the best of 2012's countdown, is by a guy from out in Arizona. This guy's got a great voice, one of the best voices I've ever heard on UZ. Here's Bruce Lev, an Indonesian girl, the year's number three music video.
Just think of me as a friend. Will true love win her heart in the end, or make me blue? How can I make her aware? My aim is true. Indonesian girl. Shining in her eyes, softly spoken words, she calms and makes me sigh. Her style lightens up the room when I'm with her. Indonesian girl.
Referring to the song as the disco song. Explain to me what he's talking about.
Well, this was a song that we did actually write in the early 80s, and my husband Tom and I, we write together quite often. And the way we recorded it at that time, which is the recording that Phil's referring to, has got that 80s feel. And I think of disco as more 70s, but in terms of it being pop, I definitely like pop music, and especially right now, there seems to be some really good things going on in pop music, and you know that's been kind of refreshing to see. My focus in my live performance career has moved towards jazz more, but I still like a lot of styles of music, you know, and there's lots of fuzzy areas between jazz and blues and pop and all of that, so. I always like things that people enjoy listening to.
Well, it would be wonderful if people saw it all around the internet. I just have no idea of how that all works, and I'm excited that you guys are going to be helping me with that, because that's one of the things that you bring expertise to. And you know, I know that that's a whole another area where a person needs to promote and get stuff out, and so my hope is that a lot of people see it, and that'll lead them to my website, and maybe some good offers out of that. We'll just have to see where it goes.
As you probably gathered by the interview, the number two music video around the world on UZ on our Best of 2012 countdown is by an artist who sings quite a bit in this area. She also won the next UZ Star contest. Here's Kathy Lyon, and get ready, the year's number two music video on UZ.
Just told you that we were through.
Another tragic event that UZ covered this year was the Pensacola, Florida flooding. Here we are riding in deep water.
Scared.
Don't, you can't slam on brakes. You can't, you just gonna have to go forward because you cannot back up and you cannot turn around here. Oh, we're fixing to drown out.
Been doing business here 20 years and having a good time doing it. Warm beer and lousy pizza or Papa Rocco's.
Zone. Love it, like you should.
And now, the number one UZ music video around the world on UZ for 2012. Well, I'm quite humbled. This has truly become my biggest hit. Here's the Enterprise Room, the number one music video on UZ for 2012. Well, that's going to do it for the show. I'm glad you stuck around for this thing. It's been a lot of fun celebrating the new year with you. 2013 is going to be a wonderful year for UZ as well. I hope you'll stick with us because there's lots of magic to come. Until then, my friends, keep in touch.